Hi, I'm Carly McAvoy. I'm doing a polynomial video today. When you multiply polynomials, you might be multiplying a monomial times a polynomial. Polynomial could be a binomial or a trinomial. When you're multiplying that way, you're really just distributing. And remember the exponent rules that you know from before. So if I have 3y times 5y squared minus 4, I'm going to take 3y times 5y squared. You don't have to write this out, but I'm going to do that. Then you have a minus, and then you have 3y times 4, right? So you're going to do those two multiplications. Let me draw the second line to make so we don't forget. And so what's going to happen in the first case is we have 3 times 5, which is 15, and we have 1y and 2 more y's, so we add those powers together to get y to the third. In the second one we have a minus, and then we have 3 times 4, which is 12, and there's no more y's, so it's just y. I don't know why half the time my y's curl up and half the time they don't. It really bugs me. But anyway, I can't seem to be consistent. There's nothing else I can do here because these are not like terms. They have different powers. This is a third degree. That's a first degree. So that's all I'm doing is just multiplying that out by distributing. If I have three terms, I'm going to distribute. I'm not going to write this out this time, but we can just look at it. I have a 1 in the front, so that's a coefficient of 1. 1 times negative 2 is negative 2. And then I have 3 plus 2. I'm going to add those powers together because that's the product rule. So I'm going to say x 3 plus 2 is 5. And then I'm going to say 1 times 4 is 4. X to the third plus x to the first. 3 plus 1 more. And that's what I'm doing this one. 3 plus 1 more is x to the fourth power. And finally, I have 1, my coefficient, times negative 5, which is minus 5, and then x to the third. So sometimes people will say, like, I don't understand when you decide if that's a subtraction and when you decide it's a negative. I know that when I see a subtraction, a subtract 5 is the same as plus negative 5, right? So I'm automatically in my head making that change. So when I see a minus 5, I'm just thinking of it as a negative 5. I can write plus minus 5x cubed, but I'm just going to write it as minus because it means the same thing and it's just a more efficient way to write that. This is done. Everything is different degrees now, so I can't combine those any further. And the second really important thing we're going to spend some time on is multiplying two binomials. And in that case, we FOIL. And that stands for first, outside, inside, and last. That's going to remind us that there's four multiplications that we have to do. So in the first couple, I'm going to show you all kinds of detail, and then we'll do a little less detail as time goes on. F. The F is the first. And the first, in this case, is x times x. That's my first term, okay? The second is outside. The outside terms are these ones that are on the outside of the problem. And that, O, is going to be x times 5. Now I'm put a plus in between there. If it was a negative, I'd have a negative in there. And then I have the inside. And the inside is 4 times x. And then I have the last. And the last is 4 times 5. So now I just go back and simplify each one of these problems. And that gives me x squared plus 5x plus 4x plus 20. And then I combine my like terms because I have like terms there in the middle. X squared plus 9x plus 20. And that's my final answer right there. Okay, so I showed kind of excruciating detail, but I wanted to write out what those letters meant and show you where they are. So let's do the second one with detail, but maybe not quite as much. So we have our first. And what's the first going to be? Well, the first is p times p, which is p squared. Then we have outside. Outside is p times negative 4, which is negative 4p. Then we have inside. Inside is negative 3 times p. And finally, we have last, which is negative 3 times negative 4, or plus 12. And when I combine my like terms, I have p squared minus 7p plus 12. And that is the final answer. I have 3 terms when I finished, even though I had 4 different multiplications. Okay, so let's see if we can do these two. I'm doing kind of several examples because later on, especially if you're going into Math 99, you have to be able to FOIL, that is multiply forward, because then you'll be reversing that when you're ready to factor. And so it's important that you really understand this process. So we have f, should have left more space above that, 3y times 4y is 12y squared. So a common mistake is that people forget the y squared, but you have 1y and 1y, so you have to add those together to get 2. Now outside, always, I should say, you should be stopping every once in a while and trying this on your own to see if you can do it without my guidance. Negative 2 times 4y, negative 8y, and finally, the last, negative 2 times positive 1 is negative 2. And now I'm going to combine up my like terms. I have 12y squared minus 5y minus 2. Always, I want to combine those like terms at the end. You can try this one on your own and pause it, or you can not. But here, what's happening is we have the first term, 2z times 2z, and that's going to be 4z squared. There always should be getting a z squared there, so please try to remember that. Outside, we have 2z times negative 3, which is negative 6z. Inside, we have 3 times 2, which is positive 6z. And last, we have 3 times 3, which is negative 9. It's negative 3 here and positive 3 there. And if I combine up the like terms, my like terms drop out completely here, and I just have 4z squared minus 9. This is a special product that we'll see in the next video, but it happens sometimes that your terms could cancel out altogether. And finally, number 7. You can try that one on your own. You should have examples to follow at this point. We're going to do first, 6m times m is 6m squared. Outside, 6m times negative 2. Inside, 7 times m. And last, minus 14. And you can write the FOIL like I did in the first 4 examples if that's helpful, or maybe you don't need it. Maybe you want to write FOIL up here to make sure you get them all. It's up to you how much that you need. 6m squared minus 12 and plus 7 is minus 5m minus 14. And that's going to be your final answer. We're going to do more multiplying in the next video, so stick with me and I'll see you next time.